Read the text very carefully. All the important parts are marked in blue. At the end, there will be a brief summary and analysis of the text. In previous part, Mrs. Oakentub and the man started off with casual conversation, by which we came to know that both are going to Stainthorpe. The lady has her home over there, and the man's intentions are different. He is going over there to meet Mrs. Oakentub, which made her very uneasy. As the conversation proceeds, the man talks about one chance meeting with the Korean girl when he was injured. That girl reminded him of his daughter, who is not alive. Yet it was enough to give him purpose to live. He pinpointed that he gathered courage to take revenge after their chance meeting in Korea. He accuses Mrs. Oakentub of murdering his wife and daughter in a car accident. Mrs. Oakentub defends herself by saying that it was only an accident, but the man called it manslaughter. Mrs. Oakentub had gone to a cocktail party and was driving very fast, even though she was drunk. She wanted to win a bet of mere £5. Her reckless behavior killed man's wife and daughter. Instead of saving them, she saved herself. The police sentenced her to 18 months of imprisonment, which she had served. But the man is not satisfied with the punishment and wanted to punish her himself. Now, the important point is the man's motive of taking revenge became clear. The source of this motivation became that young Korean girl, who reminded him of his loss. The pain and agony he has gone through takes the new shape of revenge. Fueled with anger and only purpose in his mind to take revenge, he sets off to punish Mrs. Oakentub himself. He considers her imprisonment nothing as compared to what she has done. He let her know this, his opinion, his mind, and his intentions, all the while indirectly threatening her with his actions and conversations.